Rebel Injured here for V3 Faction War. This is Estia Province and Tyranids versus Orcs. We've got two Raven Alphas on this Tyranid team. First up is Quest, already making his little tunnel, and Floyd is in there too. These guys are mobile heroes with some good offense, begin in range combat but can get some melee weapons, and they will be backed up by Hive minions. Hive Tyrant, very durable commander, walks through objects and cannot be suppressed. Some powerful offense, disruption and support begins in melee combat with a basic synapse. Red Orky team, it's Piano Man as a commander of infiltrating commander that shoots you, stabs you and blows you up. Orky style begins range combat with a twin link shooter. He's being very sneaky and taking shots at that Ravener there. Alongside, it's Torpid as a war boss, a melee hero that can walk through objects, very good offense, disruption and support from the front lines. Getting stuck in some termagants over there and rounding off the teams. Twala Lee as a mech boy, teleporting commander that fights range combat, puts out some good damage, could also support, disrupt, build structures and repair. He's on the east side there, capping that contested power. Torpid got pretty deep into Tyranid territory, but it should be okay. Oh, maybe not. Hormagort's on a retreat path. Think he's gonna go down. Down he goes. Should get revived from there though by a teleporting mech. Commando taking some shots. So I think the Orcs and Tyranids have met twice in the 2017 series of Faction Wars, and they've got one game each out of those matches. Expect Weird Boys in Tier 2, maybe all around for all three Orc players. We might see Weird Boys. And the Tyranids, of course, marching towards their very frightening Tier 3 monstrous creatures, and maybe some Gene Stealers along the way. Sluggers dropping a model to the Raveners. Range damage there. Termagants will most likely get their toxin sacks up as soon as they can to slow down those Sluggers and the War Boss, of course, when he gets back to his feet. Anyway, here he is. Here comes Twilight's mech to revive. Would that level him up? It will level him up. Half Tyrants in retreat might be able to have a look at that power up there. They found a tunnel. Gives you some red. I'm not sure if it gives you XP. I can't remember. 15 red though is pretty good. It's like killing a tactical marine almost. I think they give you 18. Stormboy is on the way for Torpid. Maybe he's expecting Warrior Brood. In fact, Quest already has a Warrior Brood on the field. They're going to be on the west side mainly, although he's bringing them to the mid right now. No toxin sacks for Quest. We have Shooter Boys with knob leaders there. Looks like we've got some looters on the way for Twala Lee. Trying to stem the tide of the Tyranids in the center and towards the east side. There's those warriors. They are keeping their melee state for now. Shooter Boys barely getting away. They make it? Yes, they do. Sluggers moving in. There's that crippling poison from the toxin sacks of the termagants, shutting them down pretty nicely there. Spore mines floating around being menacing. They now suppress. Right? Yeah. I think that's right. No, they now do damage over time. That's right. They leave a pool of crap on the floor, I think. Sluggers here with burners. A couple of power weapons, and the commander has gone melee mode here with his assassin's knife. And that's bad news for that warrior brood over there, because he does big chunks of damage with his ability. Assassinate and trip a shot is pretty damn useful too. Knockdown and a stun on that thing. Spawnmine's taken out. Warboss leading the line again. He was poisoned there momentarily. I think Stormboys, of course, can initiate for him now, so he can run in after them and not take so much damage. But Stormboys will need to be careful with that, because if they get caught by Adrenal Gland Hormagaunts, they're going to take a hell of a lot of damage from them. Warrior Brood here now for Floyd. Also in its default melee state, just ducked inside of that tunnel. That's just a visual glitch you see there. On the prowl, a whole bunch of Orcs. War Boss does not have his boss pole. He has Angry Bits. Helps him initiate and get into combat. Also a good escape mechanism. I do like to see that boss pole up though in Faction Wars. Seems kind of thematic and fitting. Charges through, got some really nice disruption there. Now tying up the Barbed Strangle Warriors. Nicely played. Warrior Brood taking the tunnel. Are we going to see an assassinate on these guys? That was it. Don't think he's going to get away though. He's got a big chunk of health coming off those warriors. That was that assassinate attempt, I believe. So they got one of those warrior brood models. Here's a Ravener Brood on the field for Quest. War Boss is still in play. Going to take a lot of range damage now, but he levels up to 2. And he wants to get his spiky armor too. He should be okay here. Raveners are forcing melee combat, which does a good amount on retreat, but he's okay. Hard boys on Sluggers. Storm boys jumping in. Barb Strangler's getting shots though. Where are the other models of this squad? All the way back here. Of this brood, I should say. 2-1 cap early on for the Tyranids. Been pretty frantic fighting early on, as you'd expect with Orcs versus Nids. Neither of these factions really known for setting up defensive positions, especially strong defensive positions in a way. I guess Orcs can do it with looters and stuff. Tier 2 for Piano Man and Twalali. Relatively heavy tier 1 for the Tyranids, which you want to do, I think. They've had a look at this power, looks like some damage on this generator. And this was completely bashed over here by Twalali. Nicely done. West side stays Tyranid blue though, as the Warrior Brood comes in with that Barb Strangler. Sluggers getting stuck in. They could be really powerful in tier 2 with their Knob Bleeder if they survive to tier 2. Almost going down there on retreat. Very nearly going down. 45 hit points. Hide the boys used to help save those shooter boys there, down to 10 hit points. Storm boys were in a bad place, but do get out of there. Haven't quite found a rhythm yet, these Orc players. Can't quite get grips on this west side quite yet. Very early on though, VP is not too important. As Piano Man and Twalali start to think about their tier 2 purchases. Need some more resources though. Uh oh, Slugger's got caught. Gonna be okay, I think. Yeah, we see Catalyst on the Hormogaunts there from Floyd. Global ability of the Raven Alpha, doubling the damage of a unit, but they do take damage themselves over the duration. And everything lived there. That was pretty remarkable. What is this? War Boss, what is he up to? He's breaking stuff. Is he just gonna have a look at the... Okay, he wants to come in and crush the tunnel, I think. He's actually going to go after the Barb Strangler Warriors, is he? No. He just wanted to be annoying and crush that tunnel. That is pretty annoying. That was the grappling hook, sending the commando flying into those Tyranids and actually disrupting a hell of a lot of them there. That was pretty cool. Lots of damage on those Orcs, but they do live. Tyrant Guard on the way for Hive Minion, known for his double Tyrant Guard tier 2s. Maybe we'll see it here. It'll be pretty fun to see against Orcs. Kind of mulching through them. Stick Bombers up on the east side now for Twalali. Nice back and forth here we've seen. We've also got a full power bash again, Twalali. Not sure if they actually built more gens there though. Charging in is the Hive Tyrant. Does have his Rending Talons for a Seismic Roar. Doesn't quite have the energy to use it right now though, and gets caught in melee by upgraded Sluggers with their Knob Bleeder and Burners, doing big chunks of damage. Catalyst again on those Hormogaunts, didn't quite pay off that time. Sluggers with Swampum doing some work here. Stick Bombs not really hitting their mark. Didn't do a lot of damage to that Capillary Tower. That is a knocked over floating Warrior Brood model. I have never seen that glitch before. I wonder if that's ever going to fix itself. They might have to kill that model or something. War Truck on the way for Torpid to support himself and his allies out in the field. Good choice. And two of the Tyranid players going for a Gene Stealer Brood. Here's Floyd's. Does like his Gene Stealer Floydy. Quest also getting some Hive Minion with the single Tyrant Guard right now. Allows him to charge in, break up the Orc lines. That Warrior Brood fella still slagging around on the floor. Hormogaunts getting... No, those were Floyd's Gene Stealers. Holy crap, he lost them immediately. And is replacing them immediately too. Here are Quest Gene Stealers. These guys are some very, very nasty power melee, and there's that adrenal rush, increasing their speed and I think their damage, while also returning health on hit, is a very powerful ability. It really helps them keep that melee superiority. Ravenna Alpha's down. Commando gets away. He's level 2. He's been in a lot of action. That's a war truck. That's torpids. Level 3 Ravenna Alpha. No war gear for Floyd. Does have his second Gene Sealer brewed up after very quickly losing his first. He must be in a tunnel somewhere because I can't jump to him. 418-305. Venom brewed for Quest. That's in response to that war truck. They might have seen it. Or it maybe he just wants some range synapse up for his Raveners and his Termagants. Beamy Looter for Twilight Elite to get some shots in on that Tyrant Guard. It can be tough for Orcs since they lack ranged plasma weaponry to deal with a Tyrant Guard without that Beamy. The Weird Boy does do good damage to it too. But he's doing a lot of damage here. Have Tyrant tries to get in and tie them up, but goes down. Big fight here. Tyrant Guard is going to go down. Nicely done. Torpid coming in to help out. Big speed buffs all around. That was a massive, massive war from all these guys. Lost the indicator for the war boss, but he's level 4 with spiky armor and angry bits. That was a good little passage of play for the Orcs. What does Hive Minion do now? Does he just go tier 3 here? That could be very risky because he's kind of depleted. They could get their power bashed again and then he wouldn't be able to really get anything up in tier 3 easily. Gene Sealer is moving on the war boss. He's trying to charge out of there and save himself, but they do take him down. Some nice XP for those guys then. Ravenna Alpha of Floyd with his Corrosive Devourer. Good damage to all targets and he can use corrosive shots to get the anti-vehicle damage. Expected to see the Weird Boys earlier, but we do see one here now from Piano Man. Awesome support unit for Orcs with the very powerful Warp Vomit to set up favourable engagements. Rending Talons up on these Gene Stealers here. I believe that's going to be moved back to Tier 3 in the next update, 2.7.1. Speaking of Tier 3, Hive Minion is going, as is Twilight Elite. 2-1. Tyranids seem to have had this contested VP for the entire game, pretty much. Wartruck lives. Yes, it does. Did we see the Venom Brood hit the field? We did see the Venom Brood hit the field right in there. Uh-oh. Sluggers have caught them with Use Your Choppers from the War Boss, and they are tearing through them. They like to use them choppers. So, we've seen a few pretty strong engagements for the Orcs. Still behind on VPs. But I think they'll be happy with the last few minutes. And they're all going tier 3 now. Floyd is kind of depleted in terms of resources because he just got a zone throw up. Which is in a tunnel somewhere, I think. 404-228. Mech Boy has the battery pack, so can support the Storm Boys of Torpid a little bit. They get themselves into trouble, which they tend to do. Here we go. Storm Boys with their Null Bleeder 2. Can they take out that Ravenna? They can. Just the one Weird Boy, though. Half Tyrant's got himself killed here. Not sure why he charged in. Was he? I think maybe he was going for the Tank Busters. And he moved out of the way. Sluggers here fighting a Acid Splatter Ravenna Alpha with Regenerate and Synapse Aura, but he was no match for those fully upgraded Sluggers over there. Were they fully upgraded? Yeah, they are. They do have their burners too. Zone Threat needs to be so, so careful with Storm Boys around. It's pretty much a guaranteed kill, I think, if they get the stun on him with the jump. Just a couple of attacks from each model would be enough to take it down. Shield wouldn't last long either. Knob squad on the way for Piano Man. That feels like a pretty quick knob squad on the field. But the Tyranids have Gene Stealers and they will put up a very, very good fight against the knob squad, especially if they have the Synapse Aura for the melee Synapse, but they don't have it. This Warrior Brood has the Thorax Swarm upgrade, which doesn't have a functional tooltip for me. But we might see that in action. Foot of Gork. Don't think it... Oh, it hit the Warrior Brood pretty nicely, actually. Took them down. Or at least helped to take them down. 404-195. Gene Slayer's getting some kills. Taking out a Slugger squad, I think. No, those are Shooter Boys. Piano Man Shooter Boys. Here's the Knob squad now. Happy to engage with his Gene Slayers here. Don't think he wants to use Catalyst, though. They actually would have been doing more damage if they did not get the Rending Talons. Because the power melee would have been better than the heavy melee against the Knob squad. But they put up a very good fight there. Knob squad backing off. And now it's Sluggers getting stuck in alongside Storm Boys. Buffs all round from the War Boss. Gene Sealers of Floyd barely making it out. Are these guys going to jump? They can't jump. They don't have the energy to do so. Level 3 Storm Boys. They've done well. Might see some pretty crazy melee fights going forward. Carnifex on the way for Hive Minion. So he did go straight to Tier 3 after losing his Tyrant God, I think. Torpid's down to three units on the field. Tank Busters, level 3 Sluggers, and level 3 Storm Boys. Warboss himself is down. Does have his Power Claw. 95 DPS, heavy melee. Going to get revived immediately here. Broodnest found and taken out. Looted Tank on the way for Torpid. And a Battle Wagon for Twala Lee, so we're going to see some pretty powerful Tier 3 units on the field for the red team to answer this Carnifex. Now, what kind of Carnifex does he get? I'm always going to recommend that Barb Strangler, especially with Knobs around, can really help control them and do big chunks of damage too. 404-169. It's basically like a Plasma Cannon that suppresses you, that thing. From the Carnifex version, anyway. There's that Power Claw, Spiky Armor, Angry Bits. Done well, that Warboss. Used his buffs well too. Floyd has preserved his Zone Throat, and his Gene Slayers did live. They're almost level 2. Didn't quite fully reinforce them though. Here's that Carnifex. He's gone for Thornback. So he's looking to go toe-to-toe with the Sluggers and the Storm Boys and the Knobs, which is a good way to deal with them. The Storm Boys and Sluggers won't do a lot of damage at all to that Carnifex in melee with its meta resistance and everything else. Knobs would be a threat, but the Carnifex will put up a hell of a fight. Are these fully upgraded Knobs? Yes, they are. 387-168 kicking off in Tier 3 there. And that was a Toronto formation you saw going off from one of the Tyranid players. Storm Boys in trouble in the background there, fighting some Warrior Brood models, and they do go down to the Acid Splatter Ravenna Alpha. Gene Slayers though, in some trouble of their own, taking shots from a tank and smacks from a War Boss. Looks like the Orcs are standing firm. Battle Wagon coming in. That's another Tyranid formation. Strange place to put it. A little bit rushed there, I think. That was a good hit though on the Knobs. Yeah, not too sure about that Tyranid formation. I would have kept it for the next push, I think. Torpid is losing his Storm Boys, so he's down to Sluggers, Tank Busters, and that tank. But now he's getting a Knob squad. We know what those guys can do with War Boss buffs. 351-168. Some commandos out for Piano Man. Stick Bombers getting into all sorts of trouble. Did they get away? I think they did. They got inside of the Battle Wagon, which is now going to charge out. So they might want to think about some anti-vehicle. They do have the Zone Throat's Warp Blast. They do have Venom Brood, and they do have the melee of the Carnifex and the Gene Stealers. But can those melee units get close to that Battle Wagon? Floyd is not using his resources here. Is he waiting for the Swarm Lord? I guess he must be. Unless he's just not paying attention to these resources. His Ravenna Alpha is down, going to get revived now though. Carnifex marching towards the west. Tank Busters are in play to shoot that guy down. And it's a Ravenna Brood getting the decap and now a cap on that west side. 320 to 168 on VPs. Tor Prince Knob squad hits the field. No upgrades yet though. It is very expensive to get your knobs fully upgraded. A lot of people complain about the balance of the knob squad in the old YouTube comments, and they sometimes gloss over the fact that these guys fully upgraded pretty much cost the same as a super unit. Down goes a capillary tower. Orcs will pretty easily take back this west side. So Tyranids need to think about countering those knobs, and they've done that relatively well, I think, with double gene stealers and Carnifex Thornback. But now they also need to think about countering the vehicles on the field. They take down a battle wagon right there, just as I was talking about countering vehicles. Double Thornback Carnifexes for Hive Minion, that is scary. Swarmlord on the way for Floyd, another Carnifex on the way for Quest. Tyranid armies starting to grow. Is that a knob squad for each player? Now it is. Twilight's got a knob squad of his own, but lost his battle wagon. Carnifexes can charge into combat. They can also spawn some Rippers, which you saw there. They actually got trampled by their own Carnifex. Beamy Looters getting shots in now. Talking about anti-vehicle, Beamy Looters doing some big, big shots, and the knob squad chasing them. I think the tank will get the last shot. No, Tank Buster Barrage getting the last shot, I think, on the Carnifex. So that guy didn't last long in the field once they set about taking him down. They took it down pretty sharpish, and now Hive Minion looking very thin, actually, with just Hormagaunt's Termagants and that Carnifex that still lives. The Carnifex of Quest also getting thorned back. No Barb Strangler Carnifexes around at all. That's a mistake, I think. One of each, I think, would have been slightly better for Hive Minion. That's easy for me to say now that he's lost one, though. 273, 154. Aiming, what's that, to suppress those genes. Just trying to set up that stick bomb throw. Got some decent damage in there. And there's that Swarmlord, super unit for Tyranids. Reinforces nearby allied Tyranids and gives them a really nice speed synapse buff. And he's pretty deadly in combat himself, so he'll put up a decent fight against a knob squad, especially if he uses his Blade Flurry ability, which is pretty nasty. Kicking off on the contested VP here. Knob squad trying to throw themselves around and do some damage. Nice special attack from the Carnifex, and here comes the Swarmlord. Gene Sealers also have found some Sluggers to fight. Don't think the Sluggers won that fight, especially with the Swarmlord helping out. Torpid though, buffing his knobs with User Choppers. The Warboss himself in there too, but does go down. Acid Splatter Ravenna Alpha doing some work here against the Knob Squad. With a lot of help, of course. There were Gene Stealers and a Carnifex in there. Holy crap. That was the Commando throwing himself into combat with the Kaboom. The Grappling Hook used to throw himself in. And he's using his Rocket Launcher to great effect against that Carnifex. Look at that damage. Gonna go down, I think. Down it goes. That's some scary damage from those rockets. Hive Chance level 4. Carnifexes have been dropping. There's only one left on the field. Zone Throw doing some work. Will do decent damage to those knobs if he can hit. I'm lacking the Swarmlord here from Floyd. Again, the Commando throwing himself in for a Kaboom, I think. He's going to go down on retreat, though. Gene Stealers weren't really live to that. Could have finished him off, maybe. Double cap for Tyranids, though. Looking pretty healthy in terms of VPs. But this is going to turn red for a 2-1. Not sure what crept forward and took red team's natural, but it was taken. And we see, in fact, a lot of stuff turning blue over there. Hive Minion using his force as well to cap up that side, I think. He's got a tier 3 Lictor, which is cool to see. Doing a lot of that sneaky capping, I think. Second Knob Squad on the field for Piano Man, and here they come. The angriest orcs ever. This is going to be a crazy engagement here. The Warboss is back to his feet and retreating out, so he's not going to be available for this fight. This is going to be a tough, tough fight for the Tyranids. You see Floyd moving back, trying to get some support here, because that is a scary sight to see. Charging away is the Carnifex, which knocked down all of that stuff, but look at this buff from Todd Ali. It's a super tough beam. Massive, massive buffs for his knobs. I'm not sure if that's an accurate tooltip, because I believe it was recently changed, although it might have just been the cost that was changed. Orcs looking strong in this fight, but can they get this Carnifex down? Tyranid formation going off. That'll be buffing all these Tyranids. Beamy Death Gun getting shots. Here comes the Swarm Lord back into the fight, using his Leech Essence to heal up and draining the health of all of these guys, and that was a good play. Tyranids did not... I would have just got the hell out here, I think, with three Knob Squads bearing down on me, but they stood firm and keep that VP. Judged it well. Carnifex almost level 3 here, and we have more Carnifexes on the way. Floyd getting one. It's another Thornback, and there's two more being produced. Tyranid is looking strong here. Looking very strong. These Genestealers have been superb. Haven't given the Knobs that free reign because they're always wary of that Genestealer threat. Talking about Genestealer threat, here they are ripping apart some Sluggers. But that's double Knob Squads on you, which is painful. Been impressed with this melee Ravenna Alpha as well at level 7. Doing some real work. Look at that. Decent chunks of damage coming off that Knob Squad there. It is a power melee weapon, although the splash damage on it is not power melee. It's all adding up though. Double cap for the Tyranids. They are well on course to take this. The Hive Tyrant getting, or trying to get a cap. Knocking these guys back with Seismic Rod. Don't think it's going to be enough to finish the cap though. Just doing as much disruption as he can before he goes down. Thornback Carnifex is all around. Who needs Barb Stranglers? That was a nice special. Orcs will take back their natural, but will it be enough? Because Tyranids flooding the map with teeth and claws here. Another looted tank for Torpid. This one is Twel Ali's. Swarm Lord came out at just the right time, I feel like. And it's done really well. There's a GG from Twel Ali. And there's a 2-1 for the Tyranid victory here. Tank going down right at the end. There you have it. That big fight on this west side, well, that's, I think, the turning point when these three Knob Squad came in and the Tyranids were able to defend against it. That was pretty impressive stuff. The level 8 Ravenna Alpha, this melee Ravenna Alpha was pretty badass. Had the Synapse Aura for damage too. Buffing those nearby Genestealers. Level 10 Ravenna Alpha Floyd with Burrow Trap. Level 6 Hive Tyrant for Hive Minion, sacrificing himself at the end to just keep things disrupted. Level 7 Commando took down that Carnifex, of course. Warboss level 6, that Power Claw, and a level 7 mech with his default weapon. There you have it, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.